io ho un polinomio definito in una matrice A, a 0 A alla n più A1 A alla n meno 1 più A2 A alla n meno 2 A n meno 1 A. Poi no, si può valutare benissimo in una matrice A, questo perché le matrici si moltiplicano, sono un'algebra. Quindi quando io ho il problema P di X con 0 X alla N più con 1 X alla N meno 1 eccetera, valutarlo in A significa semplicemente andare a calcolare sostituendo AX la matrice A. A alla 0 chi è? L'identità. Quindi qua ci va la matrice identica. Adesso facciamo degli esempi. Allora, prendiamo una matrice 2x2 per semplicità. Se io scrivo, se P di X è uguale a 3X quadro meno 5X più 1, tanto per dire un polinomio, allora chi è P di A? È uguale a 3A quadro meno 5A più I. Quindi 3 per 2, 5, 5, 17, meno 5 per 1, 1, 1, 4, più 1, 0, 0, 1, uguale 6, meno 5, più 1, fa 2, 15, meno 5, più 0, fa 10, 15 meno 5 più 0 fa 10 e 51 meno 20 più 1 fa 32. Ah, uno dice vabbè, è venuta la matrice simmetrica, ma perché io ho preso A simmetrica in partenza. Un caso. Ci siamo fino a qui? Basta, ci metto A. Attenzione che però A alla 0 è l'identità. Ok. Allora, proviamo a fare il polinomio caratteristico di A. Questo è lambda meno 1 per lambda meno 4 meno 1. Quindi stiamo parlando, è lambda 4 meno 5 lambda più 3.
osservate che pA di 1 no, non fa più. Vediamo un po'. Facciamo pA di 3 fa 9 meno 15 più 3 manco la 0. Eh sì, perché ho sbagliato quando, vabbè, no, volevo fare, quando ho costruito volevo che le radici venissero intere, ma mi sono sbagliato. Però vabbè, le radici ci stanno, le possiamo calcolare. Lambda uguale 5 meno o più la radice di 25 meno 4 volte 3, quindi meno 12 fa 13. Meglio ancora. Quindi queste sono le due radici. Ok. Io voglio andare a fare pA di A. Andiamo a prendere quel polinomio, polinomio caratteristico, e andiamo a valutarlo in A. Quando devo fare? Devo fare A quadro meno 5A più 3 volte l'identità. Devo fare 2, 5, 5, 17, meno 5 volte 1, 1, 1, 4, più 3 volte 1, 0, 0. Quanto fa? 2 meno 5 più 3 fa 0. 5 meno 5 più 0 fa 0. 5 meno 5 più 0 fa 0. 17 meno 20 più 3. Andiamo a calcolare la matrice stessa di A. Questo è un teorema che si chiama teorema di Hamilton-Pedy. Vanno dimostrato, eh? Noi lo dimostriamo, dimostriamo anche di meno. Cioè che PA di A viene la matrice 1. Thank you.
plus square minus 4 lambda plus 4 times lambda minus p minus lambda q minus 7 lambda square plus 16 lambda minus 12. So let us compute first alpha squared. When I compute alpha squared, it is easy to see that here you are. Since the matrix is triangular, and is made by blocks, you have that the product is still triangular made by blocks. The only one not trivial is this. And to calculate this, I have to second times the second column in this. Places. Then let us compute the last place, the coefficient 3, 3. 27 minus 63 is minus 63 plus 12 is 75. 48 plus 27 is 75. 75 minus 75 is 0. Then A11. 8 minus 28 is minus 20. Plus 32 is plus 12. Minus 12 is 0. 12 minus 28 is minus 16. Plus 16 plus 0 is 0. Here also it is trivial 0 because are all zeros. And the last one, 8 minus 28 plus 32 is 12, minus 12 is 0. And you see. Now I want to change my A a little bit. Let us take here 0. Then everything is more simple. The polynomial there is just the same because magic is still triangle. What changes here? There are all zeros, and therefore the computation is practically the same, almost the same, and here gives the same, gives the same result. But I want to this new polynomial. Exercise, and you will not get zero. You will get something. But in this case, you have a squared minus 5a plus 6 identity. So a squared is 4, 0, 0, 0, 4, 0, 0, 0, 9. Minus 5 2 0 0 0 2 0 0 0 3 plus 6 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So you have to compute just the terms on the diagonal. So 4 minus 10 plus 6 is 0. Then 0, 0, then 0, then 4 minus 10 plus 6 is 0, then 9 minus 15 plus 6 is 0. Because it is one polynomial that is zero at A, and that it is the one with the lowest degree. Okay? It is the one with the lowest degree. In this case, the minimal polynomial is this one. It's not a characteristic polynomial. precisely state the result in B. This matrix is 9 by 9, and it has two Jordan blocks for the eigenvalue 2, each one of size 2, and 3 Jordan blocks for the eigenvalue 3. One of size 1, and the other two of size 2. So, the minimal polynomial is strict relative to the characteristic polynomial. The characteristic polynomial is lambda minus 3 raised to the fifth power times lambda minus 2 raised to the fourth power. And you can see that here, okay, minus, because for the minimal polynomial we pretend that it's monic, so the first coefficient should be 1, so I usually write the factors, I will write minus. So. But this is not important. What is important? And that here you can have some power less than the power that appears in the characteristic polynomial. I want you to guess which is this power. Why there is 2 here and 2 here? So what?
0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Then forget for a moment the first two blocks and concentrate your attention on the last big one. When I raise the power, I calculate at 8 and I raise the power, every block behaves independent, multiplies independent, because this is block structure, and when I multiply A by A, this block multiplies this block multiplies this block, and so on, and there is no interaction between the blocks. So when I subtract 3 times the identity, these blocks becomes zero. So it's not true. So already A minus 3 times the identity at this block is 0. This block becomes 0, 0, 0, 1. And how many times you have to multiply itself in order to get 0? Only to raise to the second power, to multiply once. And the same holds for the third block. Then you can ask, but what about the first two blocks? The first two blocks, we have the same action when we subtract minus 2 times the identity. But one could say, but if I already subtracted 3 times the identity and made some multiplication, then something different can happen, cannot. Why? Because polynomial in lambda or in A, they just commute. So, in order to understand what happens here, I apply A minus 2 times the identity 2 squared power, and this gets this block 0. In order to understand what happens here, I apply A minus 3 times the identity raised to the second power, and also gets all these blocks 0. You can do the computation if you want. Please, you will have that A squared minus 5A plus 6 times the identity will be 0. In this case, compute A squared. We can compute A squared, it's not a big deal. A squared. What is this? A squared is 2402. 9 9 6 0 9 9 6 0 9. This is A squared. So I have to compute this quantity only at the positions of this block. And I have to do it to this block. If it works for this block, it will work for this block. It is trivial. Then I have to compute at this block and this block. So at this position, I have A squared is 2 minus 5. No, because this is not 2, this is 4. Okay. I squared the 3 and I forgot to square the 2. So, 4 minus 5 times 2 is minus 10, is minus 6, plus 6 is 0. You get that position, you get 0. And this works also here, here, and here. Then
times A minus 2 identity.
And it's not 0.
I forgot the square.
This is 4 power polynomial.
So this has to be. Okay, it's more complicated. It's lambda 2 minus 6 lambda plus 9 times lambda squared minus 4 lambda plus 4. So this is lambda 4 minus 6 minus 4 is minus 10 lambda cube. Then 4 plus 9 plus 24. 4 plus 9 is 13 plus 24 is 37 lambda squared minus 24 minus 36 is minus 60 lambda plus 36. So we have to compute A4 minus 10 times A3 minus 36 7 A squared minus 60 A plus 36 times A. This is what I have to compute. So I have to compute A cube. A cube 2 is 8, 12, 0, 8, 8, 12, 0, 8, 27. So 27, 27, 0. 27, 27, 27, 27, 27. This is A2. Then I compute A4.37 times 4 is 148. So I have minus 84. Thank you. this is minus 200. So 52 plus 148 is 6. Okay. So I got for this position. If this position I got right, that is zero, this works for all this, the first four position on the diagonal. It's just the same calculation. Then I have to do 32 minus 10 times 12, so minus 120. I am working from this position. Then plus 37 times 4 is 148. Minus 60 this time, because that position there is 1, before it was 120 because the position was 2. Plus 0. So minus 180 plus 180, this is 0. So this works for these two positions. And this is 0. Then I have just to make the same calculation for the diagonal for the 27. So what I have to do? I have to do 81. Minus 270 on the diagonal plus 37 times 3, that is 111. Then, no, times 9, so it is 333 minus 60 times 3 is 180. Plus 36. So minus 415. So like we have 414 plus 36, 450. This is it. Then the last computation, the 27 on the secondary diagonal. We have to do. Position, we have 108 minus 10 times 27 plus 4 times, no, 37 times 6, and this is 222. Then minus 60 times 1, and then stop, because for the identity matrix on the secondary diagonal there is 0. So we have 330, and this is 0. So you can check that for this 9 times 9 matrix, the characteristic polynomial is 3 minus lambda to the fifth times 2 minus lambda to the fourth. But the minimal polynomial is lambda minus 3 to the square, lambda minus 2 squared. This is characteristic polynomial. This is the minimum. Why? Which is actually the minimal polynomial? Your guess. So you have put here lambda minus lambda I, where lambda I is each eigenvalue of the matrix. The problem is the power. Why you have to put, we saw that first power was not enough. We computed with first power was not zero. And we have to put the second power here, second power here. Why?
presence.
This power too.
It represents the biggest length, the biggest size of the Jordan blocks for that argument. So you have 1, 2, 2, the biggest size is 2, and so you have to raise to the power. That is, you have 2, 2. If we have, for example, if we had this is 5, so if we had one block of size 2 and another block of size 3, understand? And this is quite, you can even understand why, because if we represent this for matrix like this, the action of this polynomial on each block is independent. And if we take this polynomial raised to the second power, since this block is of size 2, will be sent to 0. It is enough, this 2, it is enough to send to 0 each block with 3 on the Jordan block with 3 on the diagonal and of size 2, at maximum 2. So can send to 0 here, this one because it's size 1, this one because it's size 2, this one because it's size 2. Understand?
This is.
So, now we understood what is the minimal polynomial.
And how to calculate it. But we have to prove that situation is this, actually. Okay? And still we have to prove the decomposition in Jordan blocks. Okay?
So this is our program now.
So we now erase everything and start to prove.
We just recall what we proved yesterday. Assume that it had only one eigenvalue. I call this the only eigenvalue now lambda 0. And these were assumptions. Then
such that precisely God several blocks just in the case where we have only one eigenvalue. Okay? We prove this. And this matrix, we can also add, this is unique, up to the permutation of Jordan blocks. I can permute the Jordan blocks. If I move the Jordan blocks, but up the permutation of Jordan blocks, this is unique. Because when we have single chain, we have to put the, you remember this, every vector in this chain had to, we proved, we partially proved, because we had still to prove that these vectors were independent. But every vector in the chain should be put in this order. This. So, yes. This. Because otherwise we will not get the block. Okay. If we write like blocks, then the matrix is unique up to the permutation of the blocks. Understand? Okay. We can stop here for now.